south or north?
North.
W Hotel, one block north of here.
Yes.
I imagine you can probably find your fellow fans of superheroes congregating in the lobby and like the main entrance. And then, and Josh,
John.
That J guy.
Let's disrupt that place as we walk over there. Yeah.
As we get into the afternoon, how many enjoyed this? What do you think about this?
Yes!
Screen learning? Kind of chaotic, right? Yeah. It's interesting, it's chaotic, it's fun, it's one of our most popular things, so that's the one reason why we bring that back. If you haven't got a chance, make sure that you come up and go do the photo booth. It's a lot of fun. We'll have that open during the afternoon break as well. If you haven't done the box for your thoughts, we still have thoughts over here that you can put up.
I would say if people are looking for places to sit, they might need to kind of start scooching into the middle there.
Yeah, you could scooch into the middle so other people can join. Or let them pass to the ring. I want to make sure everybody understands how the afternoon works. It's a little less chaotic than the speed learning sessions. So if you look at your programs, we're gonna kick it over to Kavio in just a couple minutes to do some really cool stuff around learning personas or learner personas. That will end at 1 o'clock, and then you've got 15 minutes. To either go up to the fourth floor, the two big rooms upstairs, so room number one and room number two. This is in your program, if you look at your program. So for example, at 1:15, Immersive Learning, the Future of Workplace Learning with Andrew Hughes, who's right down here. That will be in the Microsoft Auditorium. And then if you're following along in your program, the Future of Work Ideation Workshop and a Mini Hack is Stella Lee. That's upstairs in room one. Navigating the New Whitewater World, Achieving the Future of Workplace is with Maya, and that's in room two. So that's how that's going to roll. And then as you notice, as you flip through, you get 15 minutes between the sessions, and again, it's either going to be in this room, or it's going to be in room one or two, 15 minutes between the three afternoon sessions. And then at 4:15, you get another break, and then you're going to come back down here for our closing keynote. And this is with Andrew McMasters of Improv Mindset. Is Andrew right here? Way in the back. So for those of you that like improv or don't like improv, you're still going to have a lot of fun. Andrew's a great guy, and he's going to help us kind of pull everything together that we learned today in his kind of Avengers Assemble presentation. And then tomorrow, I just want to make sure that we get you back here for tomorrow, because a lot of you are like,
God, I'm so exhausted. I learned so much today. I can't learn anymore. I'm going to skip day two. Don't skip day two, because we've got a digital escape room tomorrow. It's never been done before. There, is that true, John, or not? Has it ever been done before, digital escape room?
We've done this one twice before, okay, but never with this group.
But not like this. Whatever. And then we've got a panel discussion, and Chris Faree is leading that with Scott McCormick, Stella Lee, and Michael Godfrey. Here's the thing, this is not your normal panel session. We're going to have a few chairs up here, but Chris has promised me that it's going to be out of the ordinary and really, really kind of spectacular. So, and then we're going to finish up here, and I will do a little bit of song and dance about superpowers. And then we'll have some really good stuff, right? Aaron's going to talk a little bit about the coaching, because I know some of you want to do the coaching. And as soon as she's done with that, then we're going to flip it over for the learner personas. And raise your hand. Raise your hand if you didn't get a raffle ticket.
Thanks, Aaron, for distributing those. So keep those hands up, Aaron, make sure you get those. So some of you folks have expressed interest in coaching. I wanted to welcome Laura Close and some of her team members to the front. Just kind of put a face to the name if you didn't get a chance to do that. Her logistics manager, Kathleen, will be on site. And
hello, Lollapalooza Seattle 2019.
custom development, right? So it is our privilege at Laura Close Career Consulting to provide the coaching for you today. We have a wonderful lineup of talented people leaders and human design experts to sit down with you and provide these sessions. They'll be from about 1 to 4 o'clock today. The sessions will be happening in room 4 and 5 on the fourth floor. And 5 and 6. And we'll be having sign-ups start shortly. I'll make an announcement. For those of you who are wondering, Laura Close Career Consulting, of which I founded, has two tracks. One is leadership development and executive coaching for folks who are looking to move initiatives through their organizations, make the transition from senior director to vice president to executive leadership. And we also have a structured job search track. And so today's coaches can speak to you about your professional needs through development of your leadership and ability to influence and move projects, as well as your people leadership experience and challenges, and your structured job search needs as well. I'm looking forward to working with you. And as a final note, I'll say we'll make a public announcement in about 10 more minutes when registration is set up, so please come find us, we'll be right here. And if you happen to be at a very senior level in your company, please let us know so that we can make sure you're matched with the correct coach. Thank you so much.
Thank you, Laura.
All right, so let's talk about your personas. Darren, are you coming back down? Or we're just turning it over? Yeah. We're done talking. You want to meet Luann and Aaron. They're way cooler than we are. Anyway. Oh, is that a continue? I don't know what this means. So back to you, Darren.
All right. Everybody got a ticket now?
Yeah,
thank you. Good, because I'm done.
I'll be the next one.
Okay, yeah. Oh, by the way, the small part of the ticket goes in that box. If it's not in there and you don't win, that's Aaron's fault. I don't mind. Okay, so here's what we're going to do. We're going to kick it over, but I wanted to set this up. So Aaron Schneider, Luann Swedberg, did I get that pronounced right?
Yeah,
okay, good. Learning Solutions and Architects at Cavio Learning. So they're going to cover with us learning personas, because not all superheroes can fly, meaning that it's not all size. Sorry. Okay. Assuming a one-size-fits-all approach would work for your learners is like seeing every superhero has the same superpower. So I'm going to let them take it from there, though, because they're going to do a much better job than I can of explaining and setting this up. It's an activity, so you're going to have to work a little bit on this. It's what they told us. So go ahead and have at it and have some fun.
Thanks, Drew. So, I'm Luann Swedberg, Cavio Learning. Thanks for having us. Great to be here. This is the second time in Seattle, first time at this event, so thank you so much.
Hi, and I'm Erin Schneider, and we would love to have you take a couple minutes to get your phones out, because you're not already talking with your sandwiches on your knees. Grab your phones if you could. I have two phones with me, if you want to borrow mine. Scan that code and you're going to be taken to a quiz where you can find out which superhero you are. So we'll take about 3 minutes to do that. You want to just indulge us here. If you can't scan the code and you want to take a look, I have the link listed on the screen. It looks really small, which is ironic, because it's like this big.
I might have to move closer. And then I gotta open this link.
Can I just zoom in, maybe?
Are you getting it? I see something.
Yeah. Open here.
Downloading. Cool, huh?
Oh, iPhone. Hold on.
Is it?
Mm-hmm, thank you.
And the clues.
Your shoes please me very much.
Surveys or interviews with top stakeholders.
smart and he has that aptitude in mind, whereas the Incredible Hulk may not be the best person, but he's a mobile train, because his fingers are too big. It will help you uncover their motivations and goals as well. So for those of you who have completed Learner Personas or started on that journey, here are some of the things that we would suggest. So I would love to hear though what else you need to put into your Learner Personas to build them out further. So we have some of the suggestions that we have here on the screen. So give them a name and maybe something to do with their title of their job if possible. So for example, what I've used in the past is Paula Project Manager. Because it's not just saying Paula, it's saying she's a project manager as well, and it's kind of easy to remember. Roles and responsibilities, so what they do within their role. Their experience level is very important. Their demographic and diversity details are important as well. Technical or computer competence, that can be very helpful in trying to figure out how much digital training you should put into the solution. What motivates the person within their role? So are they trying for a promotion or are they just trying to not get fired? Watering holes. So that's an interesting one. Where do they go to find the information? Say you have training on the LMS. How far are they going to look in the LMS before they get in and ship and go to Google? What are his or her biggest challenges and roadblocks to success? What's getting in their way? Is it time? Is it infrastructure of the department? Is it too many projects? Is it lack of motivation? Is it, numerous things that you need? So before we move on to the next slide, I'm just curious if anyone would just be happy to share anything else that they've put into their learning personas. Introversion, extroversion, flexibility, resistance. That's great. That's a great one. Anybody else have anything to add?
MBTI type.
MBTI. Yes, I think that can be helpful too.
How they prefer to receive and send communication.
How they prefer to receive and send communication. I think that's a great one too. Thank you. You might be saying, yeah, Aaron, this is a great idea in theory, but the administrative portion of the project when we're first starting out is so much already, creating project plans, getting things signed, making sure that everything is in order to begin. Why would I add this to an already heavy first part of the project? So here are some benefits. So it can build empathy for the learner. It can also help to personalize the experience. It can create more engaging, effective solutions, and you can also help. Will also help you anticipate future learning needs. So, one of the things too that Luann and I were talking about last night at dinner, we've all had that stakeholder who comes in and says, "We have to do e-learning. It has to be 3 hours long. That's what we're going to do." And I'm seeing a lot of heads nodding, a little bit of a kind of a sigh, a little bit, because we've all been there, but. Sometimes it's difficult to get people out of that mindset that that's what their learners need, but if you can provide them with a learner persona and say, that actually won't work for these learners. They don't have that much time during the day. They don't have that type of attention span. Or even things like, your team is very competitive. Why don't we create some micro-learnings with a gamification element or something like that? Be able to show what that person looks like and what their characteristics are and what their frustrations are. Well, really paints a picture for how to best meet the learners, and it really, I have seen it open the eyes of stakeholders and project sponsors.
So Aaron kind of laid out for us a kind of framework of what the learner persona is, how we define it. So my challenge now is to let you know or get your feedback on how do you start, how do you start doing this? So as we know, if you guys have already been using this, so really the main thing to do is start gathering your information. So we've become more deliberate about this with our organization. get done them right out of the first ones, develop them. And sometimes you might go into a session thinking, oh gosh, we've been told we've got these very different audiences, so we're going to come out of here with two personas. We just had a meeting last week. Everyone said, yes, we've got all these different audiences. But after going through the characteristics, they said, no, indeed we have one audience that we're addressing. So it's super helpful to know who that you're delivering the learning to. And then actually use the personas, right? So as you're building training, as you're thinking about how you're phrasing things or how you're putting things together visually, think of Polly Project Manager and how she'll take in the information, how will she consume it? And that really helps build a more interactive and more right-on engagement. So go ahead and use your superpowers when you're doing this. So now we've got a few examples. So it doesn't have to be anything big. It doesn't have to be super professional or creative. It can be whatever you need it to be. It could be at dinner, drawing up what Peter looks like in the back of the napkin because you just talked to some learners or some stakeholders. It could be something a little bit more developed, like this purple one here with June, Jane. And putting together just whatever works for your organization or your culture to be as defined or as loose as you need it to be. There's also, you know, putting together something more creative that looks like brand to brand, you know, with the word club, whatever it needs to be. And then half the press, we were sharing this internally with our other LSAs, and they were excited about our personas as well. So this is one that actually was being developed while we're putting together our presentation. So in this case, there are really three personas that they're looking at, but we've grouped it together into one, so that as they're developing the modality and the training, they can look across and understand who the different personas are. So in this case, some of the elements that we didn't talk about would be length of time in the job. That's helpful to know. Like, are your learners new, or they've been around a while? The other thing that's kind of cool is below their photos, kind of their mantra. What are they looking for? You know, what motivates them? What summarizes them? Any thoughts or comments from the audience? What do your learner personas look like for those who do it? Want to care to share your superpowers? Yes?
I guess more of a question. Where do you run the risk and how do you manage the risk of a learner persona becoming a learner profile that now limits the opportunity for a growth mindset as opposed to we put people in buckets?
Right.
And now we've designed our learning in buckets that are perhaps limiting potential instead of springboard.
That's a great question. I mean, the minute you put something down, it could be outdated, right? Mm-hmm. So what we would suggest as the best practice for something like that is that just like any other document, it's really in breathing. You know, it's a point in time capture, but you should continually revisit that to make sure that it truly matches your audience. And, you know, just like you do maintenance for training, you might want to take a look at that on a certain basis, like 6 months or a year, to make sure that you're not falling into that.
We've had some work with building not only the set of personas that are the actual information, feedback from the original audience, but building aspirational personas. So who do we want to reach? Who are we not reaching now? Or how do we want to make them grow? And draw those up. So you draw them up, those up internally. You say, where do we want to be? Here's where we are now. But where do we want to be?
So creating also the current state and the future state of your learners,
yep.
So that you're not just developing learning for the population that you have now, but you're thinking ahead and you're thinking of what you're doing in the future and what is happening.
Who are we missing?
Yeah, who are we missing? That's a really great point. I haven't even thought of that.
Yeah. It's all about what we were showing the point earlier, meeting your learners where they are, right? Okay, so now we have time for a little activity, Great Learner Persona. Now that we've set it up for you, we have, you're missing.
we've all indulged these three people in front because this is not active participation, this is active participation. So what we want to do is show three different learner personas have varying degrees of good or bad. Of course, if you do one at all, we should just recognize that it's good. So, but we are going to show those and we're going to ask our three judges to confer for just maybe 10 seconds or so after we show it, and then hold up to the room which of the signs you think it is. We have oof, we have bam, and we have pow. I believe so. Oof is the worst.
Pow is just starting out, right?
Yes, oof is just starting out. And then you've got pow, bam, and then we have pow.
Yep.
So here's our first.
Here's learner one. So what do we have here? We've got a representation of the learner. We've got a title. We've got kind of a little bit of a mantra. And we've got some characteristics of this learner. So thinking about what you've done in the past and what we've talked about, how would you rate learner one, this persona?
Judges say,
gonna give them an oof, but it's good for starting.
So you gave them an oof, but you gave them a good job for attempting.
Yes.
Awesome. Let's hear for
judges. If you think about that and go back to the principles and the ideas that we had earlier and what to include, learner one doesn't really help you to empathize with this learner. It's just learner one.
judgment in there, like a bit of a show off, and this one is more from the person's perspective. Mm-hmm. And here's how I see myself instead of ours saying, show off.
Right. So what Chris was saying is that this is from more from the perspective of the attributes as the go-getter would tell them to someone, like, I'm really competitive. I like to challenge myself. I like, as opposed to the first one that said he's a bit of a show-off. So that's more once removed from that, maybe that came from his manager or his coworkers. We're assuming that's a he. So we've got number three now. I'll give you guys a second for that. Judges, if you want to talk for a second, then we'll see which sign you'll hold up for this one. And the judges say?
Solid family.
Judges say a solid family. Yes. If you do not want Dash to do well in green learning for them, you need to leave this room because you should really want him to do well. You know, he is, if you can see what his motivations are very clearly, it talks about his bio, it talks about his goals and motivations, but it also talks about his frustrations because we all, as much as we love our jobs and our coworkers, we do have frustrations. And it's good to get those out. Maybe those frustrations are, I'm overworked, I have too many projects. You have personality traits as well. So this, in our humble opinions, would be the best of the three, although as we mentioned, any of those would be a good start. All right, so just, we've covered a bit of ground today, and we want to keep everybody on schedule today, so we just cobbled together some tips to avoid making this your personal. So what things should you do as you consider your lower personas? So really, just kind of getting after which groups need to develop a persona. There may be some cases where you don't need a persona. Anybody have a thought of maybe some training or learning event that you wouldn't need to develop a persona? Take the time and put together one of the personas for the different superheroes, but What we've done is we created a worksheet. We have them up front. We encourage everyone to take one. And it just walks you through the process. It has some great questions to ask to gather information about your learners. And it has a template on the back that you can use to draw it out a little bit more, in a little bit more detail. All right. Great. All right, so everyone gets 5 minutes to
session, a break, and then another 1 hour session. So we're mixing up a little bit there. For those of you that want to get some career coaching with Laura Closen and her team, what we're going to do right over here, the team coaching, so as you're leaving, if you want the career coaching, what you're going to do is you're going to come over here to Kathleen. And she's going to sign up you for a time and a room. And so if your time and room happens to be at the start of one session, you can go to the coaching session and sneak into the room afterwards. But she's going to have that organized. The coaches and everybody's going to go upstairs in a couple of minutes. They're room 5 and 6. And then, like I said before, rooms 1 and 2 up there are for a couple of sessions. And then we've got a big session session down here as well.
It's big.
It's big. Did everybody get a raffle ticket?
Yes.
All right.